All right, guys, welcome to Guild Survivor, where we had two guilds, two tribes competing for the title of Soul Survivor. We had 20 plus castaways from the Death Jesters tribe and the Zeros to Heroes tribe. Eventually, those tribes merged, and that tribe is now Tribe Hakuna Matata. Yes, Disney's gonna sue us. We have 7 final castaways remaining for the title of Soul Survivor and the 1 million gold prize. We have 2 awesome events for you guys as well. We'll see what happens with Guild Survivor tonight. All right, guys, we have our final 7 here. So we have Hunter Druid, Panzer, Ganor, Jungle, Psychomantis, Miranda, and Lurchy. So final 7, Miranda, you know, you're from the original Zeros to Heroes tribe. Did you think you would make it this far?
I hoped I'd make it this far. I'm really glad that I have made it this far, though. I really think that as a Zeros to Heroes tribe, we made a couple of missteps along the way. There could be so much more of us here if we had planned a little bit better.
No, fair enough. I mean, we had some returning players from last season, as well as, you know, a ton of new players, both from the DJ tribe and obviously the Zeros to Heroes tribe. Panzer, Ganor was the winner last year. Why is Ganor still in? Why hasn't he been voted off?
I guess just because he's just been... maybe not bad, maybe not good, but nobody's noticed him, and maybe people forgot he won last year too.
Okay, well, you know, there's a reminder, he did win the 100,000 gold prize and the title of Soul Survivor against Bran in a final 2 challenge. Ganor, why, you know, how do you attribute your gameplay right now? Are you flying under the radar? Do you feel pretty safe going to this challenge?
I wouldn't say I feel safe, but... I don't know. I think maybe Ben's right. I just kind of blend in. Same thing that happened last time, and I think it's happening again.
Okay, fair enough. All right, guys. So with that, we are going to go to our first clue. Again, our clues are made by Ariana, and they're awesome. All right, the clue for this event. You have done a battle like this before, but this time there's more to score. Past and below the unavoidable scene, a ring of spots wait that make you quite clean. The focus is to chain the highest combo. Beware, for your opponents can interfere, though. With wand in hand and armor quite watertight, this small rocky island shall host the next fight. So, this next little rocky island, you guys can look around here. This is where we will have our next little event. Now, for those of you that have not done this, these little water spouts right here, they will give you a buff. And if you do this long enough for 250 stacks, which is roughly about 6 minutes of bouncing around like this, you will get a water gun as a prize. I am not kidding, it is a really cool water gun. So that is the prize if you do 250 stacks. With our event today, you guys will be trying to get the highest stack possible at the end of 5 minutes. And those 5 minutes, you'll also have your dazzling rods out. So you'll be trying to interfere with other players trying to bounce back and forth as well. You can fall off the edge, obviously. You know, these dazzling rods will stun you. You have to dodge the balls with your rod out and, you know, try to get as wet as possible. Thank you for getting everybody wet. We are not going to use any abilities. Nothing like that is allowed. No swap blasters, no bubbling, no life grips, anything like that. It is just you guys with your rods and your balls bouncing on these like a big trampoline. All right, does anybody have any questions? There's a bit of a learning curve to this one if you haven't done this one.
So to win, you have to get the highest number of stacks from jumping to the puddles?
From jumping, correct. So your dazzling rod score will not count unless we need it for a tiebreaker. So you want to have, so right there I got 2 stacks from jumping on the puddles. Here I'll have 3 stacks, and then 4 stacks, and it'll be the highest score at the end of 5 minutes. We have Midgets and Rollo tracking your scores, so you don't really need to worry about them too much. Just get as high a score as you can and try to beat everybody else. And the loser, or sorry, the winner, will win individual immunity. Everyone else will have a chance to get voted off. So we had a coach's corner a little while ago about keyboard turning, clicking, mouse turning. This is a great activity for people getting used to that dexterity and the accuracy of their mice and mouse movement. Okay, does anybody have any questions? All right, so with that, why don't you guys spread? You can go any way you want, clockwise or counterclockwise, whatever you'd like. You guys can go line up at a separate geyser here. Or as Dread would say, geyser. Thank you, Kenner. All right. So remember, guys, you will need your dazzling rods out. So if you want to get that toy box ready to go, I will start my dazzling rod, and that'll be the timer for how long you guys have. All right. Everyone's ready. So with this ready check, just make sure you guys have your rods and balls ready to go. Let's get my dazzling rod out. All right, you guys ready? Who are we gonna cheer on for this event? Who you guys think will be the best dazzling rod? That's fine, Panzersec, if you guys want to use the same spout. It's up to you guys. Okay. All right then. Remember, no abilities, no items allowed, no gliders, nothing like that. It is up to you guys after this many days of Survivor. Here we go. There's your 10-second timer.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
All right, survivors, go. Start bouncing. There they go, and I'm being intercepted with many balls right now. So who has the highest stacks? Right now, Jungle with 4 stacks. You can see the stacks sort of going all over the place. Lots of them are losing stacks, right? I see Panzer with 6, Jungle with 7. They're bouncing around, and these balls, I'm trying to get out of the way here so I don't intercept any balls. But there's lots of bounce. You can see them already falling off the edge right now here. Who is that? Jungle with 11 stacks, 12 stacks. Jungle is the guy to beat right now. All right, lots of bouncing. A bit of a learning curve for these guys. So I know there's a bit of a learning curve. And yeah, if you fall off, you have to swim back to the side. And you lose that time. You lose that 10, 15 seconds that it does take to get back here. So everyone still has about 2, 3 stacks. Pens are at 9 stacks. Jungle at 21 right now. 22 with a commanding lead. You guys got to whip out your rod and just shoot your balls all over everybody's faces. There go. Yeah, you can even knock people over. You want to try to time these balls so somebody gets stunned into the water. Jungle, again, with a commanding lead of 30 stacks. Ganner catching up with 11. Psycho at 6 now. Thank you for stunning me, jerks. Psycho at 8. This is a hard one to track. This is why we could have used a weak aura right now. So Jungle with 38 right now. Jungle's 40 is the one to beat right now. You guys have to stun him, otherwise he's going to get individual immunity. This is 1 million gold on the line. There goes Psycho falling off the edge again. Who has the highest dexterity right now? Oh, Jungle loses his stacks! Jungle loses his stacks, but they are, they're starting all over. All right, Jungle's stacks are gone, but he's the one to beat right now. You guys got to keep jumping. Hunter Druid with 9. Jump! Jump, guys! This is, for those of you watching, this is a crazy fun event to actually participate in. Hunter Drew with 13. All right, Hunter with 14 right now. Slowly catching up to Jungle's lead. Jungle back up to 9. Psycho up to 10. Pans are up to 6. Some of these guys have already done this challenge, which makes it easy if they've already done it, but those dazzling rods are going to screw them over. All right, Pans are with 10 now. Pans are with 11. Balls flying over the place, people are getting knocked out. It is tough. It is a very tough thing to do when you are micromanaging what your rotation is or hitting that one button, as well as your movement, as well as what everybody else is doing when you're trying to dodge things. This is mythic level raiding with rods and balls. All right, you guys have 3 minutes left. Have to beat Jungle's score right now. Sparty stream is for mature audiences today. Yes, there'll be many rods and balls. Everybody's getting soaked right now. Hunter Druid back up to 10. Panzer back up to 8. Jungle catching up. Miranda's not used to getting this wet. Only when babies spit up on her. Ganner having a bit of a hard time as well. Yeah, they're getting stunned all over the place. Let's see how these guys do. Let's follow them around now. There, so you can actually get stunned mid-air, and it will screw you over, so you do lose your stacks. So Jungle just lost his stacks. Ganor and Jungle both collided right now, and they both lost their stacks. So it is tough here. Psycho at 13. Psycho at 15 now. Oh, he might fall off the edge here. So this is all about mouse turning. Psycho catching up right now with 17. Everyone else back down to 2. Oh man, Jungle's on a hot streak, Hunter Druid's on a hot streak. We'll see what happens. You guys have less than 2 minutes remaining. Oh, Psycho lost his stacks right now. Lurchmaster Prime up to 10 stacks now. I think 40 is the one to beat. Oh, that he had a crazy commanding lead right now. Look! They hit each other mid-air, and they both fell into the water. That is the best and most frustrating part about this. Alright, yes, the balls can hit midair. You can actually shoot midair, and the ball will travel down and hit somebody. Psycho at 16 right now. 17, he's trying to catch up right now. Is he going to get this one? Psycho at 19, at 20. He has 20 more to go to catch up the Jungle. Jungle back up to 14, Lurchy at 11. Oh dear. Oh, Psycho lost his stacks. Lost their stacks. If only we could hear them yelling at each other out loud. Oh, there's another one. Mid-air collision of the balls. Jungle got balls to the face mid-air. All right, Jungle. All right, you guys can stop here. You guys can stop playing. I think you guys got sufficiently wet and frustrated. That was hilarious and fun as hell to watch. Yeah, and there's Hunter Druid with 20 at the end there. So, do we have a consensus there? It was Jungle with the highest stacks, we're low in midgets.
Jungle with 42 sticks.
40 yeah, two stacks. 42. Perfect. Alright, Jungle. Well, you win individual immunity and a 1 in 6 chance for 1,000,000 gold and the title of Soul Survivor. The rest of you, somebody will be voted out tonight. So, I'll give you guys a minute here to decide and create some drama with each other, and we'll give you guys a minute to decide who you want to vote out and who will be proceeding to the next round of Guild Survivor. Alright guys, so Jungle wins immunity for this round, and for those of you joining us, we had them bouncing on these, which can be sufficiently difficult or tricky depending on how you're mouse turning, but we also had them throwing balls at each other and using their rods. Yeah, this was a bit of a rough one. So, we'll see who they decide to vote out. There are 6 remaining. Alright guys, once you are ready, you guys can whisper me with who you would like to vote out of this one. You cannot vote for Jungle, he is immune. Also, please do not vote for Sparty or Firemancer. Firemancer, the running joke. Alright, here we go. Let's get these votes going. I'm collecting votes from people now. Let's see. Who do you guys think is going to be voted off? Stream, down with Miranda. Oh dear. People are on Team Miranda, right? It was down with Brand, so people are voting Miranda out. You guys. Let's see, let's get everybody's votes here. What's my missing? And I'm just missing one more vote. Pan's gonna be voted off, you think? Well, it makes sense to vote off your strongest competitors, right? Because you want to vote at the players that are really, really good and hopefully take somebody easy to the end, right? All right, let's see. who they vote out. Down with me, why? Save Miranda should be the hashtag, right? Alright. Okay, let me get this going here. I'm gonna have to turn off that weak aura in a second. Let's collect everybody's votes. All right, so I do have everybody's votes here, and I've taken a look at all of them. So once the votes have been read out, decision is final, and you'll be asked to leave the Tribal Council area, maybe go hug Tordos. If anybody has a hidden immunity idol and you would like to play it, now would be the time to do so. Let's see here. Yes, so Ganor, he has the magnificently painted egg. And Ganor, this indeed is a hidden immunity idol. Where, at what point did you get this idol? If you want to share with everybody.
It was the egg. When we were doing the tightrope running, it was the egg that was on the halfway point.
Yep. So that was a hidden immunity idol. Ganor picked it up while we did the Noble Garden event, when everybody was racing across the tightrope on Howling Fjord on the Great Lift. So any votes counted against Ganor will not count. Ganor has played a hidden immunity idol. Here we go. All right, so here we go. We're going to read out the votes. First vote, Hunter Druid. Second vote, Ganor does not count. Oh, did he play it right? Third vote, Miranda. Tied one for Hunter Druid, one for Miranda. Fourth vote, Hunter Druid. Fifth vote, Hunter Druid. So it is three votes Hunter Druid, one vote Miranda. Sixth vote, and next person to be voted off of Guild Survivor, Hunter Druid. Hunter Druid, the tribe has spoken. You've been voted off. Thank you for playing. Hope you enjoyed it. Hunter Druid has been voted off.
Dino ruined the plan. There was a plan. We had the game. She betrayed us. The bribery.
There's always betrayers. Yes, there's always betrayers here. All right, guys. Miranda, if you wouldn't mind porting us out to Vale, please. Hunter Druid is no more.
I can't. We're in combat. Oh, okay. Hunter, knife.
I'm trying. Tortoise hits like a wet noodle.
I think you guys made the right choice voting Hunter Druid out, since he pulled us in combat. Just saying.
Let the bats eat him.
No, that's fine. Let the bats eat him. why don't we just go kill Tortoise right now, and then we'll port out. Oh, man. Oh, Hunter Druid. Oh, dear.
Rallying.
All right. For those of you who remember when my original streams, Tortoise is that one that dropped my big Warhammer. All right. So, Miranda, if you want to teleport us to Vale, please. And we'll head over to our next event. Our next event was actually scheduled a few weeks ago, and I'll read out the clue from that event as well. All right, guys. So, we are down to six. The final six. We're going to Vale. Let's go find this clue. Let's see, where is this one here? So I'm trying to find... We're going to go to the Setting Sun Garrison is where you're going to be flying down to. Okay. So, while we fly down there, I'll read out the clue for the next event. At the start, we granted trappings to wear. Through each challenge, an extra task to bear. This challenge, though, they must part and lay open to the danger right at the start. While making it to the end for the victory to earn, even we don't know whether to slash or burn. Regardless of fate, you must survive the ring to gain immunity at the scarred land of the old uprising. Alright, so this next guild survivor event. So for this next event, guys, we are heading to the Setting Sun Garrison, where we have the Ring of Blades here. Ready for Raiding achievements. Now for this one, and hopefully everybody has inventory, I need everybody to strip down into nothing but their guild tabard or nothing at all. You guys will be doing this event naked. If you need to, you can vendor your gear nearby and purchase it back afterwards, or vendor whatever you have. Alright, so those of you watching here, this next event, I'm going to throw down some markers for these guys. This next event is what they'll be doing. Let's put down some markers here. Alright.
You have to take off everything?
Yeah, take off everything. Your armor, your gear, your trinkets, anything that would give you hit points. You are not allowed any gear with this event. Luckily for me, I've gotten a little macro.
We can wear our shirts and our guild tabards, right?
Yeah, you can wear shirts and guild tabards. There, you can see Sparty. Like this.
I don't have enough space.
Of course she doesn't.
Green survivor gear. Just buy it back.
Yeah, you can sell the green survivor gear and just buy it back.
Oh, I've got some junk that I can delete. Maybe.
I'll give you guys a minute here to vendor all your gear or just take your clothes off, whatever you need. You will need your dazzling rod for this event. So while you guys take off your clothes, I'll explain it. For this event, in order to win individual immunity, which is what you six are competing for, there we go, those six in the initial groups, you guys need to survive to the very end. Whoever stays alive the longest will win individual immunity. This, again, will be on a 5-minute timer with your dazzling rod. So this challenge alone can be pretty tough. These pandas do knock you around, these blades do damage. The markers as well as the stones here are the boundaries. If you get knocked out of the boundaries, I mean, I get it happens, but if you stay out too long, I will disqualify you. If it happens that you get knocked out, you get knocked out, just run back in. And, you know, do it out of fairness. But if you do die, and again, you are not allowed any abilities, no cauterize, nothing like you may have to de-talent it. You're not allowed anything special that's going to save you. And it'll be the last one to survive. If there are two people still alive after 5 minutes, we will go to highest dazzling rod score as the tiebreaker. So armor always gets really good. Yeah, makes sense to get naked after getting wet.
So anything that reduces overall damage needs to be taken off?
Yeah, anything that reduces damage. So if you have any talents, then yes, remove them. I knew there was a mage talent. I know there were DK talents that will give you, you know, immunities or procs, whatever. Again, no abilities, no talents that will save you here. It is down to your skill.
Defensive stance.
Out of fairness, you probably should remove that if you can. But some things can't be removed. So, for example, if we had, you know, a mounted... you know, if we had paladins or death knights during the scavenger hunt, and those guys had extra mounted speed, we couldn't get rid of that. Can we get on top of the poles? I mean, you can't fly, you can't use your mounts, it is up to you guys. I want you guys inside here. The spirit of the game is dodging these and dodging the blades and the pandas as well as the balls. I want you guys in there and not, you know, doing the cheese strat where you fly up on one of these little things and get the achievement. But good question. Flame Glow, thank you, yes. Any other questions? Any questions about talents? No potions, no health stones. Once you guys are getting set here, you guys can find a marker, and that'll be your spot to start at. There are 6 markers down right now. I have randomized the markers. They're fairly random. Yeah,
should
it looks like every
fortitude.
Yeah, get rid of fortitude, anything that gives you HP. So right-click your fortitude buffs. All right.
Versatility?
No lay on hands allowed. No versatility, nothing.
I can't get rid of the versatility buff.
Well, I mean, you get rid of what you can, and that's it. It'll come down to more than just versatility. Alright. Any other questions? So it looks like Lurchy is set here. The blue marker. Panzer set at the yellow. Miranda at the red marker. Jungle at purple. Ganor at green. I'm just missing. So Psycho, once you're ready, do the moon marker. Alright. We'll see who wins. Best passives win. Trust me, this is more than just passives. No challenge is completely fair. Some people always have an advantage. This is one of those challenges as well. All right, any other questions? Otherwise, we're going to do a ready check. And again, you will be using your dazzling rods, but the goal is to survive, not the score. The dazzling rods may help you screw somebody else over. We tested this event with roughly 6-7 people, and it went really, really well. It was over within a minute. But they weren't Mythic Raiders like you guys. All right, we'll do a ready check here. Who are we voting for? Lurchy? Team Miranda? Team Ganor, the returning winner? Okay. So everybody is set. Let's see here. All right. Oops. Let's give them a pull timer. All right, I'll give you guys a 20-second pull timer here. Destruction. Here we go, in 15. Go Team Miranda, down with Ganor. All right, 8 seconds.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And get your rods out. All right, get into the arena and fight. All right, Lurch has already got a score there, but score does not matter here. Surviving does, and they have to dodge these. Already people are getting down. Lurchy get taking a beating there. Jungle getting beat down. Ganor getting hit. Jungle getting destroyed right now. You actually get stunned in these multiple times and get thrown through multiple... Oh dear, big hit there. Big hit. Big hit on these guys. Jungle dropping really low. Yes, thank you for stunning me. Ball's going all over the place. Let's go... I wonder if we can fly up here. Yeah, let's go fly up here. They're all over the place right now. Ganor dropping really low. Psycho in the commanding lead right now. Psycho the tank. Psycho, oh, there you go, take some damage as well. Psycho dropping really low. Ganor really low. All right, everybody's quite low right now. Ganor quite low, getting stunned. Panzer getting a couple points. Could be anybody's game at this point. Ganor needs to stay alive. Lurching the lead. Ganor is out. Ganor is losing immunity, or his chance of immunity here. Miranda, Panzer down really low. And Miranda is out as well. Alright, and Panzer. There goes Panzer. So we have Lurchy, Jungle, and Psycho left. Lurchy in a commanding lead. His agile fat panda prowess. Oh, Lurchy takes some damage here. Jungle catching up. Psycho dropping really low. Getting, oh, there goes Psycho. Down to Lurchy and Jungle. It's going to be anybody's game here. Last two hits. Oh, is it down to 1 HP? Who's in there? Everyone's down to 2% HP. One more hit. That's all it's going to take. Oh, holy shit. We need to go back there.
Lurchy died first.
I think it was Lurchy that died there?
Yeah.
Holy crap. That was probably one of the close. That was closer than the sled game. Within a second of each other. Wow. With only 6. All right. So Lurchy was the first one to die. Then Jungle. Alright, thank you for the mass res. Jungle, looks like you win individual immunity. That was a crazy one. Whew. Alright. That was a really good one. It took us, you know, just about 2 minutes. And Jungle there with 7 points as well if we needed a tiebreaker, if both of them decided to live. But it is quite tough there, especially once you're naked, dodging all these things and dodging the balls. There are a couple little tricks as well. For dodging these, you go back and forth in these little sections. It makes it really easy. and I didn't want somebody doing this all around. So yes, we threw in dazzling rods as well, and that might have won it for some of you guys, or lost for some of you guys. All right, guys. So final six, jungle once again cannot be voted out. Wins his second immunity challenge in a row. The rest of you, one of the five of you, will be going home tonight, and the rest of you will have a 1 in 5 chance to win the title of Soul Survivor. You can put your clothes back on if you like. Put my clothes back on here. All right, let's get these guys going. Right. Who was the last one to get voted off? It was Hunter Druid. Hunter Druid was the last one. Now we are down to these guys. These final six. Alright, guys. So, once you are ready, the final six survivors, once you're ready, you can start whispering me your votes for who you would like to vote off. And I'll start taking their votes now. Who do you guys think will be voted off? Will it be Panzer, Ganor, Miranda, Lurchy, or Psycho voted off tonight? Will the DJs stay strong, or will they carry Miranda to the end? What alliances are being made right now? Alright. All right, guys. Tennis for Reserves Heroes. All right, you guys think Miranda's going home? Let's see. All right, guys. I do have everybody's votes here, all six votes. If anybody has a hidden immunity idol and you would like to play it, now would be the time to do so. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
I want to play mine.
This is indeed a hidden immunity idol. This is one of the three that were around this match. Miranda, can you explain where you got this hidden immunity idol?
I guess I technically found it when Midgets gave it to me during the Dark Maid Fair event.
And how did you find it?
She gave it to me. She said, here, have this. Enjoy.
So, during the Dark Moon Fair event, we had Midgets walking around in circles in a daze, spamming a say emote of, hey, ps, come here, I have something for you. And Miranda was the only player to stop and trade Midgets for this item. MLG play. So, any votes cast against Miranda will not count. Alright. Get everybody's votes here. All right, I'll read out the votes. Once decision has been read, or once votes have been read, decision is final, and you'll be asked to leave the Tribal Council area immediately. All right, guys, here we go. First vote. Miranda does not count. Second vote. Miranda does not count. Third vote, Miranda does not count. Fourth vote, Miranda does not count. Fifth vote, Miranda does not count. One vote remaining. The sixth vote, and the next person to be voted out of Guild Survivor, Ganor. Ganor, returning survivor, your time has ended here this season. Thank you for playing. It was awesome having you here. What a play. What a play. Miranda, single-handedly.
7% of my health.
single-handedly dismantled that alliance with that clever, clever play. Oh, man. Wow. Wow, that was good. And there goes Ganor into the blades. All right, guys. That was a really, really crazy couple games. Really, really close ones. Hopefully really fun for you guys actually playing these and dodging the blades and dodging the balls, jumping on the water spouts. And that was really good. Really good drama, really good plays there. But it is down to the final five. Panzer, Jungle, Miranda, Lurchy, and Psycho. The next event is the last event. Any hidden mirror idols can be played. And then no more can be played after that for the final four, final three, final two challenges, depending on how we decide to go with. All right, guys. That's crazy. Two immunity idols. That just blows your mind. For those of you that are Survivor fans, when something like that happens, it's just insane. All right. Ratings will continue to keep going up, says Galvin. All right, guys. Well, thank you for watching Guild Survivor. We're going to have a Heroic Hellfire Citadel run coming up after this. That was exciting. I can't believe Miranda played that. I'm sure she's shaking like she just killed a mythic boss, the mythic boss that was Ganor. So I'll see you guys next week for Guild Survivor again. Have a good night, and as always, live your life heroically.